Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am financial planner Kanna Campbell. I really hope that you're enjoying my YouTube channel Sugar Mama TV and that you are of course subscribed and the notification bell is switched on. And of course make sure you're following me on Instagram at Sugar Mama TV because this is where I create additional content for you. Alright, so today I want to talk to you about student debt and a very dangerous bit of information that is going around about student debt. Now, I'm not here to tell you off for having student debt, absolutely not. Investing in your education is probably one of the best investments you will ever make. However, the debt itself is what I need to make you aware of. I want to clarify exactly what your student debt is and how it could potentially hold you back from achieving your goals and dreams. Now, the other day, I was having a Zoom conversation with someone who booked in for an appointment with me. And she had always assumed that, you know, it's my student debt, I never need to worry. This is what all these particular financial influencers recommend. Don't worry about it, it's interest free. And so I asked her a few questions and turned out she didn't really know much more about her student debt other than it being interest free. So when I pointed out a few key things, I could see the color in her face starting to fade away. And I wanted to make sure that whilst this conversation was limited to just her and I, the privacy of that conversation, I need to make sure that you guys are aware of this so that you can make your own informed and educated decision when it comes to your student debt and how you choose to manage it. All right, point number one you need to know about student debt. Okay, this is the most important thing I want you to be aware of. Number one, it is indexed. Whilst your student debt is interest-free, it is indexed to inflation. Now, this particular girl I spoke to, her student debt was over $80,000, which I have to say is not that uncommon or excessively high. Now, if we use an inflation rate of 3% per annum, that meant her debt was going up in excess of $2,400 every single year. So while she never thought she had to really worry about her student debt, she's actually getting deeper and deeper into debt by $2,400 every single year. Now, not realizing that, because she always went with the surface level advice, she became suddenly quite concerned. The second thing you need to know when it comes to student debt is it limits your ability to borrow money. Yes, if you go to the bank and you want to apply for a home loan to buy, say, your first home, which is really exciting, and you still have student debt, the bank are going to look at your application, run a credit check, and see, oh look, you've still got student debt. Student debt that's 3, 4, 5 years old. They will consider that debt because you need to service that debt as well as potential new debt, and it may run the risk of reducing your ability to borrow money. Now that may mean that you miss out on buying the house or home of your dreams by $20,000, $40,000 because the bank wouldn't lend you the full amount of money that you actually needed. Now in this particular case, this girl that I was speaking to was also in the process of saving up a deposit between her and her husband who also had student debt. And she didn't know that this would actually reduce the amount of money that they could potentially borrow. So it meant she had to either look at paying off her student debt quickly or in fact downsizing her budget of the dream home that she wanted to buy. The third thing you need to think about when it comes to student debt is the bigger the debt, the longer and the harder it is going to be to pay it off. Now, the reason why I'm saying that is quite often when people go and invest in, you know, tertiary education, they think, oh, it's fine, I'm just gonna wait until I get my first job or I'm a year into my first job and then I'll start making extra payments. Well, easier said than done. It's very easy for life to, you know, get carried away and we forget about our student debt and we just let it sit there, maybe with our employer taking out some money to help pay it off. But the repayment plan that your employer takes out is very, very small and it will take you years and years to actually realistically pay this debt off. What my advice is, even whilst you're studying and potentially working part-time, try and put at least some sort of repayment strategy in place, even if it's only $100 a month, because it will mean that when you go and start paying off this debt, it's smaller, therefore quicker and easier to pay off, and you'll pay less interest through the indexation because the overall debt is smaller. The fourth reason why you should want to pay your student debt off is cash flow. If you are earning over a certain amount, your employer has to take out some of your pay to help pay off this debt. Yes, it's a small amount and it takes, as I said, years and years to pay it off, but that is still valuable cash flow that belongs in your pocket, not the ATO's. And when you think about it, that extra cash flow that's your money really could be going towards far more exciting goals and experiences in your life. That extra money could go towards more holidays, could go towards more experiences, it could go towards more of your financial goals, such as having a bigger and better deposit for your first home, investing more, perhaps even putting more towards your superannuation so you can enjoy a more luxurious retirement. When you have more cash flow, you have more options, and who doesn't want that? And then the fifth point I want to make towards paying off your student debt is the rules and regulations may change. Now, this is very much my personal input and opinion on this, so please take this with a grain of salt. But I always like looking for signs or trends or warnings that something may change for the worse so that you can, I guess, be ahead of the game, be really proactive and prepared. Now, if we look at what our country has gone through over the last 12 months, we have had huge stimulus packages given to people in need, which were very valuable, that helped get us through a very tough and challenging economic time, which we're actually not all the way through. Obviously, I'm talking about COVID. Now, if we think about all that money that has been given out, and we also look at other trends that have gone in our educational system, where university fees have gone up, where they have started taking repayments from people earning at a lower amount than what they previously were. When we look at how the government is now chasing people who have moved overseas to start paying off their student debt. These are all trends that indicate rules are changing and they may also continue to change. So whilst yes, this may be an interest-free loan, perhaps they may change that indexation to an interest rate. It may go from being at an inflation rate to a nominal interest rate. They may start increasing the amount of minimum payments on our loans. They may start putting these fees up. There are so many things that they might do to start changing the rules and regulations, which are going to make it harder, more expensive, and take longer to pay this debt off. So what I would be doing if I had student debt still, I would be making sure that I make extra payments on that debt. So this is what I would be doing if I had student debt. Number one, I would make contact with the ATO and find out exactly how much student debt I owed. Number two, I would be looking at a budget and working out what I can change or shift around in my budget to allow me to make extra repayments towards this loan. As I said, even if it's an extra $100 per month, that's over $1,000 each year coming off my student debt. Number three, I would set mini financial goals around reducing this debt. Number four, I'd even give myself a few little mini rewards along the way once I achieved those goals. And then finally, I'd be using this opportunity at looking at where I stand financially and my responsibilities financially and set some exciting financial goals and strategies around this. Now, of course, if you have toxic debt, such as credit card debt or a personal loan, I would most definitely prioritize paying that off first because it is most likely that that interest rate is higher than what it is with the indexation of your student debt. So I would target that first. But the moment it is paid off, I would then move on to reducing the student debt as quickly as possible. Now, for people who have absolutely no toxic credit card debt, yay, which is amazing. They do have some student debt, perhaps a little bit of emergency money, but they're really motivated to start investing and build long-term sustainable wealth. This is what I recommend you do. You start having a few different goals focused around the three key points. One strategy focuses on making extra repayments towards your student debt. The second strategy focuses on making sure that you always have enough emergency money in place so that you never get into credit card debt. And then the third strategy, make sure that you continue on investing and achieving your financial goals. Yes, it may mean that you can't invest or save as much as you usually would because you're now trying to reduce your student debt. However, what it means is overall, you're strengthening and making more financial stability for yourself in your life. And of course, the moment that student debt is paid off, it frees up your cash flow and you can use that available resource to now pump more into your emergency money or savings and of course, more into your investment goals. So do yourself a massive favor, get the monkey off your back, and I promise you, I have never ever met someone who said to me, I really regret paying off all my student debt. This is a serious financial goal to have, and it's really important that you understand the truth, the devil in the detail, as I say, behind student debt and what it really costs you and the limitations that come with that. All right, everyone, thank you so much for watching Sugar Mama TV. As I said, I'm Kanna Campbell, and I am a licensed, qualified financial planner here to help you with your financial goals and dreams. Ciao for now.